pittas and kaphas are there. So they have to differentiate these various interpretations of normalcy. Most of the people, they are normal, number one. Number two, 3 points, golden rules of health, you have to understand. Each and every person has a normal standard, one. Each and every person has normal elasticity standard. What is normal elasticity standard? Even a person within the power or ambit of his resistance, he can be abnormal to a particular level. The body homeostasis will take care, that is known as ojas. The homeostasis will take care of his health and he will be repatriated to normalcy very gradually, number two, automatically. Number three, that is plasticity of a person's ability of normalcy, in which if he takes rest, either avoids work or does a lighter type of work or refrains from certain activities, that normal rest will repatriate. So wherever automation, normalcy, automation, repatriation, settlement, and homeostatic ability, five things fail, then only you have to go for medicines. So pulse diagnosis, immediately it should not start with medication. It should understand how much he is normal, and normalcy of a person is different from normalcy of others. Lot of people we have tested in our diabetology lecture, most of the people are naturally having low sugar with them. Most of the people genetically, hereditarily, occupationally, it is known as occupational therapy or occupational pathology. Based upon a person's tension, the area where he works, the amount of work that he executes, the amount of tension that is unavoidable in his responsibility, liability and execution, these things are to be counted before counting everything. That is why it is known as grade. Pulse diagnosis that deals with your nature, specific nature. We cannot have a clinical, there are two records, clinical record and personal clinical record. Your personal clinical record will be plus or minus 10 to 15 points from clinical records, certainly. Because you are entirely different, no doubt you are part of the world, but you are having your individuality. Pratyekatha. On the basis of that pratyekanyaya, that's why most of the people are living in the fear of disease rather than diseases. Most of the people living in the fear of diseases, living in the fear of more diseases. They are having two extremities. One, negligence about big diseases. Unwanted phobia or fear about unwanted diseases or casual diseases. So this is due to negligence by which they suffer, as well as due to overestimation of their own things, not including the biopsychological as well as the ecological record. They are considering that it is different. So what is your normalcy? Elasticity, plasticity, adaptability, internal curability, then go for drug. If it is not possible, go for divinity. If it is not possible, go for death and be born again. What is the problem? Are you clapping for the last solution? So how to do is that? This is known as Sapta Prakriya. How to do this Nari Pariksha? Sparsha, that is by touch, pressure, touch it, press it, move it, hold it, unhold it, rehold it. These are known as Sapta Prakriyas. So touch it, then press it. If the immediate touch cannot give you the message, press it. If that particular area does not give that, change it by a yava. That is, a width distance to that area, you can feel it. With the tip of the area, back to feel, there are two points, feeling points. There are two feeling points. One is the revealing point and second is the feeling point. And feeling points are also two. Revealing point is your nadi, feeling point is your finger. Even in feeling point, there are two feeling points. You are just feeling it by your mind, also feeling it by your fingers. In between that fingers and mind, there is one internal additional force. The sound that you hear, where you can hear the sound? Which organ is meant for sound? Only here. It is the center of audition, but now you are feeling it in the finger because you cannot hear it by ears, because it is a spot-based sound emanation. It is a spot-based sound emanation. So unless you press your fingers here, the feeling sense, that is the thwak, the feeling sense, the touch sense of your body, that along with that of shruti or shravana, it is known as thwak srotra sambandha, or touch audition therapy, or touch audition methodology. You touch it, you are not fixing your ears, nobody is hearing like this. That is why even in stethoscope, it is based on two centers. One center is for the touch, Second tension is for audition. The same touch and audition and interpretation should be given, replacing the stethoscope by means of your psychoscope, by means of our intellectual scopic energy by which we have to analyze these things and interpret. So you have to do the work. That is a bidirectional work of both the ends of the stethoscope by your hands. So by touching, touch it. If you don't feel, press it. If you don't feel by pressing, change the position. If you don't feel, hold it. Then if you don't feel, unhold it, then rehold it. Within this prakriya, we can get the interpretation. And Vaidya should have Ashtama Siddhis in pulse diagnosis. Number one, there are certain factors which are even humorous. I told in one seminar, if the pulse is disturbed, you cannot have clear prediction. If the pulse rate of a person is disturbed, you cannot have clear prediction. Then somebody asked me, if the pulse is not disturbed, why we are coming here for prediction? Then I added that it is known as exomaladial influential factors. Apart from the maladial factors of your body, if there are additional disturbances of restlessness, exhaustion and other things, if you are not placid, if you are unexhausted, if you are totally in a mood to commit yourself for proper inspection, then only we can give you clear indication. So immediately if a person comes, he cannot be diagnosed like that. A person must be in a casual mood, in a calm mood. In either a non-executive, he must be neither sluggardish nor over-exhausted. So a proper mental, intellectual and physical balance, apart from the diseases, I'm saying that. Apart from the diseases, apart from that specific disturbance, no other disturbance must be available for clear inspection. It is first how to filter or distill exomaladial factors at the time of diagnosis. This is a prathama siddhi. Second thing is supportive lead or independent lead. It is a siddhi. What is supportive lead? For example, there are five symbols. One is a facial. Second is by tongue interpretation, third is by lips, and fourth is by nail, and fifth is by eye. It is known as optical mode, sensitive mode, or facial mode, or nail. All of these things are just commonly observed. Initial observation, secondary observation, tertiary observation. In initial observation, face, tongue, lips, nail, and eye, they are considered. In secondary observation, the dhatuka, it is known as dhatuka pariksha, where a person's urine, where a person's blood, serum and other things are considered for testing. That is secondary. Third thing is ahara, nidra, pita, jirna, ruthu, ityadaya. Where is food intake, consumption level, taste response, digestion and vomiting or emetic sensation, menstrual discharge and its regularity, all of these various physiological explicit dimensions and demonstrations are made in the tertiary level. A person who is having supportive lead, by means of all of these things, he must take them as inputs and interpret the pulse. That is supportive lead. This is supportive lead. Independent lead is a person touching the pulse, he can interpret what is your ahara, what is your nidra, how you sleep, whether you are somnolent or insomnolent. There are innumerable levels, insomnia, hypersomnia, hyposomnia, semisomnia, somnambulism, innumerable reflections of appetite, digestion and somnolence is there in medical record. By touching these things, a person can interpret the irregularity of the biological or bio-collective function, that is independently.